Vande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Vande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandana Vande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopiyano Samayuktam Binda Vanam Manohar Vancha Kalpataru Vasaki Pasindu Vivaja Patitanam Pavuni Bhavishnavi Bhyo Namo Namaha Mukankaroti Vachalam Pangung Lang Haitagirim Yatki Patamahang Vandi Paramananda Madhavam Brindavi Tulside Bhai Piyavi Kesavasaja Krishna Bhakti Vade Devi Satva Vatvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottama Deving Swaraswati Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadesh Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagodvaranya Deyam Sada Parivabhagnam Avishtadoham Tethasvadam Siva Virinchanutam Saran Vetatiham Panatopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahagurusuti Charunar Vindam Yat Pada Pallavana Kushandamani Chatai Visfurjita Kimapigopodushvadarshi Purana Nuragara Sasagara Saramurti Saradhikami Kada Kivam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Ajanulambita Bhujo Kanaka Bodhato Sankirtanaika Vitaro Kamala Yataksho Visham Baru Dijavaru Jugadhar Mapalu Bande Yagat Priyakaru Karuna Bhataru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin Chamuktin Chadada Sinitam Bhavanurupen Sada Naranam Ganga Taranga Ramaniya Jata Kalapam Gauri Nirantara Vibhushi Topam Bhagam Narayana Mananga Vata Puharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavi Shanatham Vagi Sajasya Badane Lakshmi Rajasya Chavakshasi Jasyasthi Hide Sambhir Tvam Nishinga Maham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Dharmo Praj Mushita Koitava Atta Paramaniramasaranam Satam Vedyam Bastavamatra Vastu Shivadam Tapotraya Unmuranam Simada Bhagavati Mahamuni Kriti Kingva Paririshwaraha Saddo Hridiya Varudvati Kriti Visusubi Statkanat Dharmo Prajita Koitava Atta Paramaniramasaranam Satam Vedyam Bastavamatra Vastu Shivadam Tapotraya Unmuranam Simada Bhagavati Mahamuni Kriti Kingva Paririshwaraha Saddo Hridiya Varudvati Atro Kiti Vihi Susubhi Statkanat
Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagat Guru told, until and unless 100% Saranagati submission is there, one cannot speak about their absolute truth boldly. Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagat Guru told, until and unless there is 100% submission, Saranagati unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan, one cannot speak about their absolute truth boldly. The source from where we are hearing absolute Harikatha, the source from where we are hearing absolute Harikatha is called Guru Pad Padma. The absolute source from where we are always hearing transcendental Harikatha, we are feeling some reaction inside our heart, that source is surely Guru Pad Padma. Be sure. We should not express any doubt and suspicion about Guru Pad Padma. And it is sure, those who are not going to have Sadguru, and at the same time those who are not going to have 100% submission, they cannot understand secret Siddhanta Vichar. It's impossible. Because it is written in Shastra, Acharyobhan Purusho Vedaha. If in my life I am not going to get a Sadguru, Paramahansa Sadguru, and if at the same time if I am not 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of my Paramahansa Guru, in that case to speak Harikatha is quite impossible. We common people don't understand, don't know basic Siddhanta. That is why this kind of contradiction and this kind of, you know, problem coming inside our life. Acharyavan Purusho Vedaha. If I am not going to get Sadguru in my life, then my hearing Harikatha is on the basis of assumption or interpretation. Okay, this must be this assumption. Whereas about Harikatha, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. If I depend upon Prabhupada, if I depend upon Keshav Goswami Maharaj, if I depend upon Bhakti Bhavanpuri, any Sadguru, to hear Harikatha, I must be sure about this point that there is no possibility of any upper Siddhanta. Any wrong Siddhanta cannot come, any wrong Siddhanta we cannot expect from the lotus mouth of a pure devotee. Try to understand this basic point. We cannot expect any wrong Siddhanta from a Sadguru, Sad-devote, Sadguru. Impossible. In whole life, a pure devotee, Sadguru can never speak any wrong Siddhanta. Better he can stop Harikatha. But he cannot speak any wrong Siddhanta, not possible, because his Harikatha is connected to that transcendental world. Harikatha is being transmitted from there and they are uttering. Harikatha is beyond time, space and matter. Harikatha is beyond any time, space and matter. It is not motivated for any particular person. But the duty of an acharya, the duty of an acharya who is speaking Harikatha, is to regulate the whole devotional society, to cut misconception if at all done previously. Harikatha is never motivated for any personal reason. Specially, you all know it very good, the source from where you are hearing Harikatha is free of anxiety. Why? Because there is no desire to get garland, no desire to get pranami, no desire, no desire for pratishtha, nothing. Lab, puja, pratishtha, not there. The source from where you are hearing Harikatha, if you don't have 100% belief, then your hearing Harikatha is not perfect. Big problem. And total Bhagavad Dharma, whatever Harikatha I am discussing for year after years after years, I am discussing, maybe before you could not hear, thousands of Harikatha, Bengali, Hindi, English, Oriya, different languages speaking all the time. Up to now, nobody could detect any Siddhanta Virodh, because it is not my credit. Harikatha coming from Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, if at all, if I am in line. And Prabhupada specially Prabhupada declared already that those who are Gauriya devotees, actual Gauriya devotees, those who are actual Gauriya devotees, they never deserve any special credit for any speciality, if at all there in them. That is the speciality of Sadguru, from where you are hearing Harikatha. Prabhupada already declared, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, a genuine Gauriya devotee, a real Gauriya devotee, they never deserve any special credit for at all any speciality, if at all there. If at all any speciality is there in any devotee, if he is at all Gauriya devotee, he never speak like mad. He never demand, because he is sure that Harikatha coming from special source, if I am collecting money for Gauriya Math, it is done by Prabhupada and Guru Bhargava. Because Prabhupada speaking, those Gauriyas, they are sure about it. Harikatha Kirtan or any kind of speciality, if at all there, for the reason they are doing special Guru Seva, Hari Seva, they never deserve credit, because they know all power coming from up, the original source. This you forget. It is not man-made. All power coming from the original source. I already told many times, it is my request unto the lotus feet of all devotees, those who are hearing, those who are going to leave me, I have no objection about it. I am not nervous. Because 100% again prove what I am speaking, 100% perfect. It is not motivated Harikatha. Harikatha can be applicable, Siddhanta which are applicable for anybody. Those who are having some weakness, they think, oh, he is speaking for me. This can be there. That's not all at all. Future generation to come, for them it is applicable. Past generation gone, for them, present, for time, space and matter. You know, beyond any time, space and matter. So actually, I already told many times, if I am inclined unto lotus feet of Gurupada Padma and Prabhupada, Gauriya Math, then and only then I can expect power to come to me, inside me. The moment up to which I am going to show inclination, submission unto lotus feet of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Bharga, Gauriya Guru Bharga, without criticizing. Because in Bhagavatam it is written, Na Marto Buddha Asuyeta Sarvadeva Mayo Guru. And you can Come to me, I can show all documents what Prabhupada speaking. Article to article, number I can show you. I am sorry, I couldn't translate all articles of Prabhupada. I think it is, all articles of Prabhupada, if translated, if circulated all among each and every devotee all over the world, I think then nobody can cheat them. Otherwise, common people, they have no idea about even Guru Tattva. It's one kind of laughing stroke. They have no idea about Guru Tattva. Guru Tattva, Gurudev can make mistake. How possible? I am Mayavadi. I am Mayavadi. Gurudev can, how Gurudev can make mistake? Specially, you have never heard this kind of Harikatha. Where from this Harikatha coming? From my brain? You should understand now. You should, first of all, it is my request unto your lotus feet, everybody. To everybody I am requesting. First of all, before Harikatha, it is my request, you must come on a neutral platform. You know it for sure. I have no particular, I have no group, I have no organization, I have no math mandir, I am not going to foreign country, I have no deposit, nothing. Where from jealousy can come? Where from? Where is the source? If at all jealousy is there, then Sarup Shakti Vitti, Harikatha, Harikatha is the Sarup Shakti Vitti of, Harikatha is the Sarup Shakti Vitti, Sarup Shakti Vitti. Harikatha is Sarup Shakti Vitti. Nobody can make Harikatha, nobody can, somebody can pass lecture. But Harikatha is impossible, Bhaktivinoda was speaking. Only those who have Vaikuntha Parshad, Harikatha is possible for them. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Vaikuntha Jagatere Vyaktigan Chara Harikatha Kehei Bolite Parena. In Bengali, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. The moment up to which I am going to keep connection with my Gurudev and Guru Varga, surely, if somebody doing some extraordinary thing, massive thing, extraordinary thing is impossible to do. Havoc thing, havoc preaching everything, you should be very sure about it, all done by the power of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati or Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Bhargava. The moment you are going to feel all my power, is all my power, it is my credit, all useless, only I am the, you know, fittest candidate, then sure, I am not Nirmatsar. Bhagavad Dharma, Gauranga Katha, Nirmatsaranam Satam. Those who are Nirmatsar, they have no jealousy. No jealousy. In my whole life, I have not seen even a single letter of lecture of Guru Pad Padma. Kesav Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, they are speaking heavily sometime. But Matsaratha, jealousy is not there. Jealousy cannot be there. Impossible. Because otherwise Harikatha can stop. Automatically Harikatha can stop. Harikatha cannot appear if there is aparat. Nirapekha na haile dharma na jaye rakshani. Try to understand. If you at all have Sadguru, then and only then by the mercy of Sadguru, if your submission is 100% perfect, you can understand my Harikatha. I am in Vyasasan, so many devotees, they passing remark, those who are from India and different part, especially from India, very senior devotees. They told me, those who are hearing Harikatha from right source, from long time, Gauriyamath, only and only they can realize your Harikatha. Other people can misunderstand you. Many time, many body told me. From Chandigarh, here, there, for different place, Maharaj, your Harikatha only somebody can realize, those who are hearing Harikatha, authentic Harikatha, from long time. They are habituated. Those who are having Sadguru, submission is perfect. Then and only then they can realize, otherwise not. I can give one by one example. Prabhupada speaking, Shastra is equal to Bhagavan. My Guru Padma speaking Harikatha, or the source from where you are hearing Harikatha is material source, it cannot so happen. Even material source, then this kind of Harikatha you cannot hear. Impossible. Where from come? If there is no connection with this eternal world, Prabhupada speaking, Shastra is equal to Bhagavan, Shabda Brahma. Sound incarnation of Bhagavan, Bhagavad Ji Mahaprana sound incarnation. So it can only appear unto the lotus, unto the, on the tongue of a genuine devotee, those who are in line, Vaikuntha messengers, only they can speak Harikatha. Out of jealousy, one cannot speak Harikatha. And Gauranga Dev, Mahaprabhu, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, who himself is Krishna, he already told, from Chaitanya Charitamrita you can find, Shastra Guru Atma Rupe Apnare Janai. In the form of Shastra, in the form of Guru, or in the form of Krishna himself, different Atma Rupe. Krishna want to express in front of some devotee or those who want to become devotee, genuinity there. For them, in the form of Shastra, in the form of Guru, in the form of Krishna himself, in the form of, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Nityananda Prabhu, this way Krishna can manifest inside the heart. If Gurudev Sadguru is not there, your luck is very bad. If Sadguru you are not going to get in your life, then only assumption and calculation, estimation, interpretation can guide you. So you cannot get the taste of actual Harikatha. There should not be any particular, there should not be any group color, nothing should be the only neutral platform. And you will have to discover yourself in the background of Anantadev. Always and every time you should realize that I can go away from this material world anytime. Anytime I can go away. So with whom I can have some cruelty, with whom I can have partiality, fighting mood, cannot have. The symptom of a pure devotee is that they cannot have any partiality, they cannot have any fighting mood, nothing. And in Bhagavatam, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving special instruction to Uddhav Ji Maharaj. If you are devotee Uddhav, I am sure you are devotee. I am sure. Krishna Bhagavan saying, if somebody is speaking all rubbish against you, if somebody is speaking all rubbish against you, you will have to bear it. You will have to bear it. Don't try to insult him. Ati badam titiksheta nava manneta kanchana. Never try to insult. You try to insult me and see my reaction. I cannot give answer. But whenever you are speaking anything against my Guru Padma Guru Varga, I am dog. I can bite you. Be careful. Tumi to takur, tomar kukur boliya janu. You can test me. If you have some doubt about me, I am ready, that you can test me. And I can give one or two examples that if you force me to believe that all our Guru Varga, they are useless, fallen soul, they are not even human being. In that case, I can bite you. It's quite natural. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teach me. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when you find that Ballabhatta going to insult Siddha Sai Pad, that I cannot accept the commentary of Siddha Sai Pad, Mahaprabhu, Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya, he was very angry. He said, you have that kind of audacity, you don't like to give honor, you are pros. Those who are not going to obey Siddha Swami, they are pros. One example. Mahaprabhu became very angry. Why? You don't obey? You don't honor? So much audacity you have. All Guru Varga, they have some speciality. Surely. They have some speciality. time to time, Abhirbhaptiti, Tirobhaptiti, it is the duty of Guru Vaishnava to glorify their name, fame, everything. Those who are out of, you know, jealousy mood, they can do it. It is sure. I can also give you answer. It is the instruction of Prabhupada. To become angry, Prabhupada speaking, to become angry in the case one Vaishnava is being insulted by somebody, is called bhakti. To express angry attitude, the moment where you find pure Guru Vaishnava is being insulted by somebody, if you express angry attitude, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, it is bhakti. If you don't express angry attitude, you can lose your bhakti. You don't know this kind of Siddhanta. Never heard. Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami never express any angry attitude. When Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj insulted by somebody, then he was like lion. So many examples I can keep. When Vallabha Bhatta went to Vrindavan at the bank of Jamuna, at the bhajan kutir of Rupa Goswami Bhad, that time Rupa Goswami Bhad was writing some book, Rasamrita Sindhu. And Jiva Goswami Bhad, the small, you know, Jiva Goswami Bhad, he was serving Gurudev with hand fan. Jiva Goswami Bhad was serving Gurudev with hand fan. And Gurudev writing. In the meantime, he is coming. What you are writing? Dandavat, Dandavat. What you are writing? Well, actually, Rasamrita Sindhu. Well, this book after compilation, after writing, I can edit it. Huh? Okay, I can help you. He gone. Jiva Goswami Bhad become very angry to see the false ego of Vallabha Bhatta. Then he started going towards Jamuna. He told Gurudev, Gurudev, I like to take water from Jamuna. In the meanwhile, going to catch Vallabha Bhatta and speaking, what kind of mistake you have seen? What kind of mistake you have seen in the writing of my Guru Padma so that you wanted to rectify it? Then he become nervous. Then in the meantime, Shastra argument going on. Then Vallabha Bhatta was set up to see the great proficiency of that, you know, small boy. He's a great devotee. Great honor for Gurudev. It was this way. He come back. From then onward, Vallabha Bhatta was very careful about speaking anything to anybody. Gaur, Guru Vaishnav, they are always very careful because they have their controlling over their writing, over their speech, over their mind, over their, you know, sense organ, everything is Goswami. Nobody in whole life could discover that Madhav Goswami Maharaj was very angry or Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj was angry. Follow? Nobody could discover. So much, you know, tolerance, so much thing. So you see, to give answer to anybody who is going to insult Guru Bhargava is called bhakti. But surely you cannot insult that way. Cannot insult. We have no right to insult anybody. But we can speak indirectly. Because Krishna Bhagavan saying, Paraksha, indirect word I like very much. Krishna Bhagavan speaking, indirect word I like very much. And those Rishi Muni, they like indirect word. They always like indirect word. So I like indirect word all the time. I like to see. Indirect word is very good. Indirectly, Krishna Bhagavan always want to see indirectly. So, Krishna Bhagavan always want to see indirectly. So, Rishi Muni, they are also like to, you know, they also like to speak indirectly. I can give the example. When Shankar Bhagavan was insulted by Dakha Bajapati,
He was abused. Then what was the reaction of Nandiya? What was the reaction of Devi, Bhagavati Devi? What Bhagavati Devi is speaking? He had to give answer. You know. So indirectly, we can speak indirectly, Harikatha, indirectly, to stop this kind of thing. Always, it is a procedure, we will have to do it all the time. So you see, indirectly we can speak, there is no offense in it. And Dharma Prajjita Kaitava Atta Nirma Saranam Satam. Dharma Prajjita Artho, there is no contamination at all. So pure, so pure, so pure that we cannot imagine. So pure. There is no contamination of karma, jnana, nothing. No contamination there. So all the time you see, this way, Dharma Prajjito Kaitavatta Parama Nirmasaranam Satam. Nirmasa, there is no jealousy. Those of Bhagavad Bhakta, their devotees, of Gauriyamat, they cannot have, they should not have any jealousy, nothing against anybody. They are not speaking anything rubbish against anybody. So, Dharma Prajjito Kaitavatta Parama Nirmasaranam. Parama Nirmasaranam. Not only devoid of jealousy, fully, totally clean. And all other people, those who are going to pass lecture about Bhagavad Dharma, they have no right. Because Bhagavad Dharma is so excellent, he is equal to Bhagavan. Shaddo hidiyavaruddhate krithibhi shushubhis tatkhanat. As soon as you hear Bhagavad Katha from right source, immediately Bhagavan can get confined inside your heart. Immediately, Bhagavan can come and sit inside your heart. This is the excellency of Bhagavad Dharma. And Bhagavati Devi is speaking in front of Dakkha Prajapati before living body, Sati Devi. Doshano paresham hi guneshu sadhavo grinanti kachitna bhavadrisha diyaha. Doshano pareshami guneshu sadhava. If at all any defects is there, if at all any defects is there in somebody, Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava going to find some quality in them, good quality. Doshano paresham. If some defect is there in somebody, they don't know, no problem. They find some quality in them, good quality. Doshano paresham hi guneshu sadhava. Suppose somebody is speaking, Kesav Goswami is very angry. Then the meaning coming to the Paramahansa Vaishnava, he is not angry. He is so merciful that he cannot bear that you are going wrong way. He likes to get some solution immediately. That's why he is angry. Vrindavan Das Thakur is angry. So it's wrong. So pure Vaishnava, they are always trying to find some quality, good quality in others, not bad qualities. So those who are Shiksha, Diksha Guru, they are sometimes chiding Shishya. It is a separate thing. It is not a, you know, it is a separate thing for their benefit, going to indicate their point out their defect. Hey, you should not do this way. So, dosana paresham hi guneshu sadhava grinanti kechit no bhavadrisha diyaha. But you're like Brahman, and never find any quality in somebody, always find some defect. Gunanscha falguno bahuli, gunanscha falguno bahuli karishnavo mahatamaste abhiddat bhavanagham. Go through the Dakha Yagya topics. Gunansha Phalguna, very, very small quality. Very, 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 very futile quality. Not so important. But Gunansha Phalguna, very small. I know you have so much patience. You are so, you can do bhajan. This way, patience. You know, you are converting. And no quality, nothing. But Guru Vaishnava is going to find some quality in him. Gunanscha phalguno bahuli kari. You are great. You are doing this and that. You are, you know. They are not fine in him. Gunanscha phalguno phalguno bahuli karishnavo mahattamaste mahattamasteishu abhiddad bhavanagam. Teshu, in them, this pure Guru Vaishnava always going to find some good quality. Okay, you are great. You can do Hari Bhajan this way. They are going to speak. Follow. A pure Tattvavid sadhu can never mistake any Siddhanta Virod cannot make. It's not possible. A Tattvavid sadhu who is in line with Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati and Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Gauriya Parampara, it is impossible they can make any mistake. They cannot make any mistake, impossible. They cannot make any mistake, impossible. Now point is that we cannot adjust with Guru Vaishnava. That is the main problem. That's why we find some fault. We cannot adjust with Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. That is the main reason for why we find some fault. I already told what Prabhupada speaking, who is Shastra, Shastra is equal to Bhagavan himself, and in the form of Shastra, Guru, or Bhagavan himself, in different way Bhagavan can express inside in front of us. Guru Vaishnava can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. So how you can criticize? Guru Vaishnava can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. So how we can? How? Prabhupada speaking, preaching means you will have to speak, you will have to glorify Guru Varga and Guru Varga and Bhagavan. Prabhupada speaking, preaching means you will have to glorify Guru Varga all the time. Preaching means you will have to glorify Guru Varga all the time and Bhagavan. That is called actual preaching. If I get deviated from the track of Guru Bhagavad Padma, it is not actual preaching. So, driven by mental pressure, manodharma charito hai, Prabhupada speaking, if we want to understand Shastra by the help of our mental, by the help of material mind, Prabhupada speaking, if we want to understand Shastra by the help of our material mind, in that case we can become failure. Shastra Siddhanta can get manifested in front of inclined devotees. Saranagata. Prabhupada speaking, I am not speaking. Shastra and the meaning of Shastra can get manifest in front or get manifested in front of inclined devotees. Saranagata Bhakta. Who is having 100% belief in Gurudev and Guru Varga? That kind of bhakti in Bhagavan. The kind of bhakti he is having in Bhagavan, same bhakti or more than Gurudev. If we have that kind of bhakti in Gurudev, 100%, in front of him, the inner meaning in front of him, inner meaning of Shastra can get manifested. Those who want to think that I am a Pandit, very false ego, that I am a Pandit. He is speaking in front of him. The real meaning of Shastra cannot get exposed, cannot come. By his body, speech and mind, if he can show inclination unto a lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, Parampara, then and only then the meaning of Shastra can come, exposed inside my heart. Otherwise not. Otherwise impossible. How to get adjusted with Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan? We are going to lose patience. We cannot bear the glories of Guru Vaishnava, that's why we are going to become angry. Follow. Prabhupada speaking, all Gauriya Math, they are going to serve, they will have to serve Chaitanya Math. Prabhupada speaking, and Gauriya Math, Chaitanya Math not coming, Gauriya Math, Chaitanya Math coming from that eternal world. Gauriya Math or Chaitanya Math coming from that eternal world by the invitation of Prabhupada. By the invitation of Prabhupada, Gauriya Math and Chaitanya Math coming from that eternal world. Chaitanya Math or Gauriya Math, the place where Rupa Goswami was speaking, Dibbat Bindaranya Kalpadrumado Simadatnaga Singhasanastau Sisi Radha Sigovinda Devupeshtali Vishabhamanus Marami. It is that kind of place where those great devotees are serving the divine Kabal Radha Krishna, Radha Govindo, very tasteful way, very tasteful way, decorative way, very tasteful way. Prabhupada speaking, it is a place where Radha Govindo, the divine kind, getting service, excellent way by those great devotees, very tasteful seva getting. It can be compared, not compared, it is just equal to Rupa Goswami Dibbat Bindaranya Kalpadrumado Simadatnaga Singhasanastau Sisi Radha Sila Govinda Devau Pestalevi Sebhamanu Smarami. Where all Sakhi Manjaris sat together serving Radha Govinda Divine Couple in a Jogpitsi Mandir. That's why in the morning time, Arati Kirtan Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Kalpo Toru Tale Ratno Singhasana Pari Sabosoku Beshchito Kishoro Kishori. Radha Govinda is, you know, surrounded by all Gopikas, Manjaris, they are serving, is called Gauriya Math Vrinda. Gauriya Math is equal to Jogpit Vrindavan. I heard from Guru Bhargava, they are speaking this way. Gauriya Math, there is no infighting. Who told there is fighting? Who told? No fighting. Those who are fighting, they are in society, not in Gauriya Math. Inside Gauriya Math, there is no fighting. Inside Gauriya Math, those who are committing opera and the lotus feet of Prabhupada, they are doing something. But inside Gauriya Math, there is no fighting. At all, if I find two Guru Varga have some external, that is called very sweet game. It is like what you say, well, love and rapture, if done for the same common divine goal, love and rapture is going to be happened for the same unique, excellent, common purpose of Krishna Seva, wide acclamation can be given. Not criticism. Radharani fighting with, Radharani's group fighting with Chandravali. For Krishna Seva. It is very good, excellent. There is no fighting in Gauriya Math. Who told? Those who are staying in Gauriya Math, I always shout and speak solemnly that I am staying in Chaitanya Math. There is no fighting inside my heart. I have no jealousy, nothing. No group, no partiality, nothing. So there is no question of any problem in my life. So anybody go against me can go. Prabhupada speaking, until and unless I am not inclined unto a lotus feet of Gauriya Math and Chaitanya Math, then nobody can speak me Gauriya. Prabhupada speaking, who all, Prabhupada writing one article, Sri Gauriya Mathe Kahara Nityabas Karite Pare, who all can live in Gauriya Math eternally? Prabhupada writing one article. There Prabhupada speaking, those who are not inclined to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Gauriya Math, they are not at all Gauriya. They cannot be called Gauriya. They are not Gauriya devotee. Prabhupada speaking. If there is any separate judgment, if there is any separate judgment as shown by Chaitanya Math, then he cannot be, you know, given, cannot be given this title Gauriya. Follow. What is the duty of a Gauriya? To sing the glories of Guru Gauranga Gandharvika all the time, 24 hours, non-stop, is a symptom of Gauriya. They must be ready. They must be ready to sacrifice their life in the fire of Sankirtan Jagga all the time. I am bound to speak this introductory katha before starting Bhagavatamrita, because there also you can get confusion all the time. Because there is comparison, different kind of devotees, what kind of devotee, showing what kind of devotion, all different comparative statements there. Follow. We must get adjusted with Bhagavan. We must get adjusted with Bhagavan. All proper adjustment, Prabhupada used to speak this. Prabhupada always used to speak this point, all proper adjustment. With all articles surrounding us, those who are having some connection with Krishna Seva, all men and women around us, we should find one suitable connection with them, suitable harmony with them, surrounding situation. Otherwise, all the time, mental disturbance, mental craziness can come and cannot allow me to do Hari Bhajan. Krishna is Ananta Brahmana Nayak. Krishna is controlling the infinity universe. Krishna is universal truth. Krishna is, you know, all pervading, and I am very tiny soul. I am very tiny soul. How I can get adjusted with Krishna? Krishna is all pervading. Krishna is omnipresent. Krishna is universal truth. Krishna is the, you know, Supreme Lord. Infinity Brahmanda, they are everywhere, Krishna is there. Then how it is possible for me, a teeny soul, to get adjusted? If I cannot adjust it with Guru Vaishnava, if I cannot get adjusted with all great, great Guru Vaishnava, only if I can find fault with them, then my adjustment with Guru Vaishnava is not there. Then how I can get adjusted with Bhagavan? How I can show that I have adjustment? All power can be taken away. All power can be taken away by Guru Varga and Gurudev and Bhagavan. If they find some false ego coming in me due to appliances, this is that. So how I can get adjusted with Krishna so that there can be a loveful relation, prema? So that there can be a loveful relation with Krishna? How it is possible for me to get adjusted with Krishna? Impossible for me? Prabhupada speaking, we should know it. Asray jatiya jibgane asray. We are the shelter. Krishna is the shelter of us. We are asrita. All pervading Supreme Lord. Predominating Absolute and predominated Absolute. Predominating Absolute, Bhagavan, and predominated Absolute is all jivas, everybody. Now how we can get adjustment with them? You know, how adjustment can be done? This is the main problem. If you cannot understand Krishna Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva, nothing, if you get deviated and we say we are successful, how successful? Shastra will have to, Tasma Shastra Bhavan, your argument, we cannot do argument. Argument cannot bring any solution. Only we'll have to know actual Shastra Siddhanta. Any kind of prejudicial idea, any kind of fighting mood can throw you away from bhajan. You can get disconnected from me, get lost, big problem. You know, Baba speaking, the sun god is 14 lakhs time of bigger than the earth. Sun god is 14 lakhs time bigger than this earth. And that fission and fusion reaction going on inside sun god is so heavy all the time. All the time sun god is glowing. All the time sun god is glowing. And the temperature inside sun god, I cannot calculate. You can ask one scientist, astronomer. If we try to approach sun god, we can burn up. If we try to approach sun god, from sun god, sunlight coming, so how many light years it is taking for sunlight to come here from sun god? We should know all this tattva. Follow. Sun is one glowing, you know, glowing bulb, like if we try to reach sun god, we can burn up. And if we cannot, if sun god go away from our this kind of, you know, our astronomical figure, if sun god is vanished, then we can die. Because due to era, then we can die. Too much cold, we cannot see anything. We can become blind, we cannot see. If sun god is not there, if sun god go away from us, from our range, then we cannot see anything. We can see nothing. And we can die due to cold weather. But Bhagavan making so nice adjustment, the sun god is there. How long distance sun god from us? And 14 lakhs time bigger than this earth. And how long away? And now in the morning time we are getting sunlight, we are getting hot, we are getting heat power, we are getting light, we are getting adjusted with the sun god, or proper adjustment. The place where Bhagavan Anantadev going to put the sun god, we can feel adjustment, proper adjustment. If sun god coming too near to us, we cannot see anything, we can die. Because very big thing, if coming too near to us, we are so small, we cannot see anything. If one big, you know, structure of anything coming in front of us, then we are so small, then if too near to our eyes, we cannot see. If too distance, too long distance, we cannot see. So all proper adjustments should be there. Distance and place, all our vision power, also there should be proper adjustment so that we can see everything. So by the mercy of Supreme Lord, we are getting some adjustment with the sun god. Sun god is safe distance from us. Sun god is safe distance from us. We can see sun god. And by the mercy of sun god, we can see everything. And from sun god, temperature coming, we are getting nourishment, we are getting all facilities. And the night time, sunlight coming via moon god. Night time, same sunlight coming to moon god, and from moon god we are getting some light here on this earth. For that, Aushadhi means you know, herb and keepers, they are getting some nourishment day by day. This way, we can get adjusted. We have our limited vision power. We have our limited vision power. Range of vision is limited. So it's just like this example is applicable. Krishna, it is impossible for us to make relationship with Krishna. It is impossible to get adjusted with Krishna, but still possible. Still possible. What is the ratio? What is the ratio of adjustment? First of all, our Guru Kippa, our Sadguru Kippa, Prabhupada many times told that Guru Padma, Prabhupada many times, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Prabhupada many times told, Guru Padma is a transcendental or transparent media. Guru Padma is the transparent and transcendental media through which we can try to see everything. And by the mercy of Guru Padma, we can see as it is. So we should approach Krishna. We should approach Krishna through Guru Padma, through Sampradayik Bani Vaibhav. We have to approach. By the help of Sampradayik Bani Vaibhav, by the help of Gurudev, we must approach Krishna. So we can get adjusted with Krishna. In that case, very easily we can get adjusted with Krishna. All by the power of Guru Padma, not personal power. All by the power of Krishna. All by the power of Guru Padma, Guru Vaishnava. We can get adjusted. We should get adjusted with Krishna, Ishwar. And we bonded soul, always try to get adjustment. We bonded soul, always try to get adjustment with things which is just opposite of Krishna Bhajan. Krishnetara Vastu, those items and man's and woman's and items, they have no connection with Krishna Bhajan. With them we like to get adjusted. That is very sad, that is very painful. We like to adjust it with things just opposite to Krishna Bhajan. We like to get adjusted with person, those who are just against Krishna Bhajan. We like to get adjusted. Like our woman, like our husband, like our wife, like our daughter, like our friends and everything, and a son we like to. Prabhupada speaking, the mundane adjustment between husband and wife, between parent and children, between friend and friend, as well as between master and servant, is all wrong. For those adjustments will result in death in the long run. They will have death as their goal. So we must reject the limited adjustment on the basis of which we are going to pass all rubbish remark. We'll have to avoid it. So we must reject the limited adjustment on the basis of which I am going to pass remarks about Gauriya Math, Gauriya devotees, Chaitanya Math, Prabhupada, Guru Varga, Gauriya devotees. I will have to stop. So we must reject the limited adjustment power. We should reject all Adaiva Varnasram and its adjustment. And as those find and will finally find death and nothing else as their goal. Worldly adjustment are all deluding, confusing. Worldly adjustments are deluding, because after all, in all such process, death is inevitable. We cannot avoid. we cannot avoid. So first of all, how to get adjusted with, how to get adjusted with Bhagavan, how to adjust it with Bhaktivinoda Thakur, how to adjust it, how to get adjusted with Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, all our Guru Varga. Impossible. Harikatha is not motivated for anybody. If we have some weakness, it can touch our heart and say this. No. This way, actually, Brihad Bhagavatamrita is a very, very nice, excellent book about Brihad Bhagavatamrita. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is written, if we fail to develop adjustment with Guru Vaishnav, Gauriya Math and Bhagavan, we can get lost. Some biased conception, some logical interpretation can contaminate our heart. We can lose all our facility to hear Harikatha. We can lose connection with Bhagavan. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing, Sanatan Kaila Grantho Bhagavatamrite Krishna Bhakto Bhakti Tattva Jani Taha Haite. About Vyad Bhagavanta, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing, Sanatana Goswami Pada writing such a book like Vyad Bhagavatamrita, Bhagavatamrita. If we go through this book, then we can know all clear, we can develop all clear conception about who is Krishna, what is the Tattva Siddhanta of Krishna, who is Bhakta, and what is Bhakti. What different kind of mode of bhakti can be there? Oh, countless different kind of bhakta, devotees can be there. At present, there is a scarcity of Harikatha. Prabhupada speaking, at present there is a scarcity of Harikatha. Where is it written? Vaishnav chinite nare devere shakti. Even those demigods, they cannot understand the mood of Vaishnav. So how I can pass, any remark about Guru Vaishnav? Even demigods, they cannot understand who is, pure Guru Vaishnav. All our genius Guru Varga, whole world, they have no conception about who is Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, who is Kesava Goswami Maharaj, who is Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, who is Madhava Goswami Maharaj. No conception. Why? Why? No conception, they don't know. For a long time I am speaking, Abhirbhakti Thitirava, they say we never heard that Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj, who is Goswami Maharaj, they don't know. Why? Why? We don't like to express their name, we don't like to glorify them. Great offense. Now actually, due to Kalikal is the age of controversy, they cannot get the cream, so nice Amrita, like rain, like torrential rain of Amrita coming. But we are going to ignore it and going to point out some single point. Amrita, like Amrita, torrential rain. Amrita coming from eternal world. We cannot drink that nectar, but only we can point out, this is the point. There is a condition of Kalikal. At the age of controversy, age of fighting. So, to understand the limit of devotional practice, to understand the limit of devotees, devotion, to understand the actual tattva of Krishna, we must understand this. Especially this Kalikal, age of controversy, very limited age, we are going to live 50 years or 60 years, or maximum 70 years, this is the age limit. within this age limit, very small lifespan, within this lifespan, if you are going to start argument, then we cannot find any solution. Tarka apadishto. Try to ignore. Who is speaking what about whom? Okay, ignore it. Don't try to concentrate. Try to hear Harikatha. So life is very limited, lifespan, unstable life, and brain, our mental capacity is very, very limited. There is no possibility that we can go through all Shastra and understand all Shastra Siddhanta. Guru Vaishnav can go through all Shastra Siddhanta and get the cream for us. It is a facility for us, we can get. This way, all different kind of, you know, Prabodhananda Saraswati Bhat speaking, na? Kriya saktanu dhig, bigadatavata dhig cha jamin, dhigastu brahma ham badana parifullanu jaro matino, kin etanu sochamo, visharo samatyanu naropasuno, na kesanchit lesho pi ahaha milito guruna. Sometimes I think to stop Harikatha and start Harinam only because of this situation. Again, I think about the instruction of Prabhupada and Nityananda. By the desire of Nityananda and speaking Harikatha, by the desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada and Guru Varga, they have the standing instruction on you, on me. Guru Varga, Prabhupada gone, you know. So to get ultimate seva inside Vrindavan, what is the target of Bhagavad Bhagavatamrita? Bhagavad Bhagavatamrita, we can see day by day, gradually, Bhagavad Bhagavatamrita, I mean Sanatan Goswami, gradually can guide us, gradually can guide us up to the inner core of Vrindavan. Up to, finally. But when you start, you can find some preliminary things, gradually discussion can go on. From Godavari top there, from there we can go, finally you can go up to the inner core of Vrindavan. There is the ultimate. Sanatan Goswami Charan. Sanatan Goswami writing, Sanatan Goswami Pad, before writing Bhagavad Bhagavatamrita writing, Jachukeno upadishtam te vatsa niskrishya tashyame swaram prakasayo khipram khiram bodher rivamritam. It is the comment of Uttaradevi. I can come to the point, but first of all I like to discuss the point what Rupa Goswami Pad want to speak about Bhagavad Bhagavatamrita. First of all, I like to discuss the point given by Rupa Goswami Pad. Rupa Goswami Pad speaking, my Guru Pad Padma, Rupa Goswami Pad speaking, my Guru Pad Padma writing one book, name is Bhagavad Bhagavatamrita. All secret Siddhanta, Bhakti Tattva, Bhakta Tattva, all the glories you can come to know very easily. Rupa Goswami Pad in Rasamrita Sindhu writing, Simat Prabhu Padam Bhujai Sarvo Bhagavatam Brite Bhakti Kritasti Gudapi Bhakti Siddhanta Madhuri. My Prabhu, my Gurudev, my Prabhu, Sanatan Goswami Pad in Bhagavatam Brita Grantha book, writing all the secrets of Bhakti Siddhanta Madhuri. Very secret, but he was successful to write in a very lucid way, very sweet way, very clearly. So very impossible. So, to understand all the secret Siddhanta Vichar of Bhakti Siddhanta Madhuri, continuously we'll have to go through this book to understand the glories. You can remember, years after years, day after day, month after month, we are discussing all secret Siddhanta Vichar, which is rare. Still, I cannot cut your doubt because I have no name, fame, position, I have nothing. No disciple, no garden, nothing. Eh? That's why you express doubt about me. This kind of, after, even after hearing this kind of all Siddhanta Vichar, I was speaking that day, even after hearing this kind of rare Siddhanta Vichar, month after month, year after year, feel they are going to pass this kind of remark because they think me light. I have no position, no rank, nothing. If this kind of harikatha coming from an international sadhu, I know you all, but I don't care what to do. So you see, Simat Prabhu Padambujai Sarvo Bhagavatam Rite Bhakti Kritasthi Gurapi Bhakti Siddhanta Madhuri. My Prabhu Sanatan Goswami writing so secret Siddhanta Vichara Bhakti Madhuri, this, you know, sweetness of Bhakti Madhuri Siddhanta Vichara, very secret. If you want to get, you must grow through this Bhagavata Amrita under the guide, not under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. In the name of Harikatha Kirtan, in the name of Harikatha Kirtan, those who are going to misguide the common people, we common people want to be cheated by them, that's why you are cheated. Baba speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Not only that, but also this has become a traditional fashion of the day. We need glamour, position, rank, everything. And Maharaj Sambhava has no glamour, position, rank, nothing. So, if he is speaking something heavy, we can protest. But you cannot prove that I am speaking Ravi Siddhanta. No, never. You cannot prove. He can never prove. Not possible. Now, I can go to the other slok. I mean, Sanatan Goswami writing in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, Jat-chukena upadishtam, te-vatsa niskrishya tashvame, swaram prakasaya khipram, khiram bodher ribamritam. Follow what I say. Sanatan Goswami writing. Bujjavad Sanatan Goswami. This kind of book is rare, impossible. Impossible, this kind of book you cannot find. So important book. Uttaradevi is the mother of, I have to speak the background. But before that, you must increase your patience. First of all, I like to discuss one point so that you can directly realize this, that life is very unstable. You can remember when Parikshit Maharaj was given warning. When Parikshit Maharaj was given warning that within 7 days we will have to leave this material world. When Parikshit Maharaj was given warning by Samik Muni, his son, Siringi Rishi, he gave curse. When Parikshit Maharaj was given, last word, warning that you are going to leave your body within 7 days. Then he leave everything and sit at the bank of Ganga and started asking about absolute good. Follow. Many times Prabhupada used to speak, if I seek the path leading to the ultimate good, If I seek the path leading to the ultimate good, then I must ignore the countless voices of popular wisdom and listen only to that of the realized soul. It is impossible that I can love Prabhupada and X Vasudev or Y Vidyavinod. How it is possible? If I love Prabhupada, if I have tremendous love for Prabhupada, automatically I will have to cut relation with them. Because they criticize Prabhupada and Gauriya Math. If I have strong relationship with Prabhupada, at the same time, how it is possible for me to keep relation with them? Impossible. So you see, it's impossible. So if I seek the path leading to the ultimate good, then I must ignore the countless voices of popular wisdom and listen only to that of the realized soul. Who is realized soul? Who is not? Who is Siddhantavid? Who is not? The only one symptom is that they cannot make any mistake in their Siddhanta Vichar. Not even a single Siddhanta Vichar they can make. So long as Y Vidyavinod and X Vasudev was in line with Prabhupada, they were excellent personality. This kind of writing, this kind of speech, almost impossible on this earth. This kind of writing and speech is almost impossible in the earth. On this earth, that kind of writing was possible for Vidyavinod and X Vasudev. But when they went against Prabhupada, same Vidyavinod, same X Vasudev, but same man, but power gone. When they're writing just wrong Siddhanta. You can come to me, I can show. Wrong Siddhanta all. Same Vidyavinod, why Vidyavinod writing about Madhvacharya and, you know, his Siddhanta, everything. And same why Vinod writing that some another book in which he is writing all wrong Siddhanta. In which he is writing same Siddhanta. By the mercy of Prabhupada, he was successful to write. He was successful to write Siddhanta. But now, after leaving Prabhupada, writing all wrong Siddhanta. Same man, writing wrong Siddhanta. All rubbish. So long as they were in connection with Prabhupada, they were successful. That was the power of Prabhupada. As soon as they started thinking, it is our power and all gone. Everything gone. So at the bank of Ganga, Parikshit Maharaj sitting and asking for the absolute benefit. All Rishi Muni, they are coming. They are not the absolute source. When finally Sukadev Goswami reaching the absolute source of Harikatha, then Sukadev Goswami speaking Harikatha in front of Parikshit Maharaj. Parikshit Maharaj asking this question, Atho Prichyami Sansiddhim, Atho Prichyami Sansiddhim, Yoginam Param Gurum, Purusha Seha Yatkaryam Mihamanasa Sarvata. I put a question, I am going to put one question in front of you. Hey Gurudev, what is the how I can get the highest benefit? Atho prichyami sansiddhim yoginam param gurum purusha seha yatkaryam mriyamanasya sarvatha. The man is mortal. To all is human and man is mortal. So what kind of bhajan we can do? Then Parikshit Maharaj, going to hear Harikatha, Sukhdev Goswami speaking Harikatha, Sukhdev Goswami giving advice, Etat nibritta mana namichyatam akuto bhayam. If you like to become fearless, you are fearless or not? How you can understand I am Satsisha? How I can understand that Prabhupada is Sadguru? How I can understand the Keshav Goswami Sadguru? How? Their fearlessness can prove. They are always fearless. They are enjoying divine power. That's why Atho Pichyami Sangsiddhim Yogunam Param Gurum Purusha Seha Yatkaryam Miya Manasa Kharvada. Man is mortal, going to die very shortly. I like to put question in front of you. What bhajan I can do so that I can get success? Atho Prishyami Sangsiddhim. Sangsiddhi, not general siddhi, Sangsiddhi. Sangsiddhi is only possible by Sankirtan, Harinam Sankirtan. Sangsiddhi is only possible by Harinam Sankirtan. So the question of Parikshit Maharaj is, Atho Prishyami Sangsiddhim, Yoginam Param Gurum, Purusha Seha Yat Karyam Miya Manusa Sarvata. Those who are going to die very shortly, for them, you please, speak out what is our bhajan. Then Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, Etad nibritta mananam michataha makuto bhayam joginam nipanirnitam harirnama anukirtanam. Etad nibritta mananam michataha makuto bhayam joginam nipanirnitam harirnama anukirtanam. O Rajan, etad nibritta mananam, those who are feeling detested with this material world, material enjoyment. Etad nibritta mananam, those who are feeling already disgusted, detested with this material enjoyment. For them, it is a suggestion that they can go for Harinam Sankirtan all the time. Etad nibritta mananam. Michyatam akutabhayam. Ho Rajan, if you want to become fearless, then you must do Harinam Sankirtan. Etad nibritta mananam michyatam akutabhayam joginam nipanirnitam harirnama anukirtanam. You can go on hearing and chanting Harikatha. Harikatha Kirtan is the, topmost procedure through which you can satisfy your life. Your life can come out successful. And after Harikatha is over, Sukhdev Goswami is going to get permission from disciple. Well, I like to go away. Then Parikshit Maharaj pay dandavat and glorifying Gurudev. Gurudev! Anugrihitosmi, kitarthosmi, anugrihitosmi, bhavataha yat karudha karunatmanaha, sravito jachame shakshat, anadi nidanam harim. What speaking? Parikshit Maharaj speaking. That kitarthosmi, anugrihitosmi. I am successful. I am blessed by you. Anugrihitosmi. I am blessed by you. Great mercy. I have received a great mercy from you because you spoke Harikatha in front of me. Oh, Paramahansa Gurudev, you spoke Bhagavat Katha in front of me. Kitartosmi anugrihitosmi bhavata yat karunatmanaha sravito jachame shakshat anadi nidanam harim. You are successful to glorify all the glories of Bhagavan. I am successful hearing this Harikatha. Oh, what to speak? I am successful. Then Gurudev speaking, Rajan, hey Rajan, before starting Harikatha, when Sukhdev Goswami started speaking Harikatha in front of Parikshit Maharaj, Sukhdev Goswami was bound to speak in front of Parikshit Maharaj, Rajan, Tvam tu marishe iti achintayo. Hey Rajan, you must remember all the time, every fraction of second. Rajan, Every fraction of second you will have to remember that you can go away from this world. Hey Rajan, every fraction of second you will have to remember that you can go away from this material world. You'll have to remember all the time. Then and only then you can concentrate in Harikatha. You can have a real demand to hear Harikatha. Otherwise, with challenging mood, you can hear Harikatha. Oh, Maharaj can speak wrong Siddhanta. Arey, Maharaj cannot speak wrong Siddhanta. Whole world can come. Maharaj can prove. There cannot be any wrong Siddhanta. Motivated fighting. So, Parikshit Maharaj, hearing the warning from Sukhdev Goswami, Rajan, Tvam to Marishe iti adhin. Hey Rajan, you are going to die. Always try to remember over and again. This can give you faith in Harikatha. This can help you to concentrate in Harikatha. Otherwise, material mind can go here and there. Fickle mind. And after Harikatha is over, after continuously 7 days Harikatha's worth, continuously 7 days Harikatha's worth there, after Harikatha is over, same Gurudev, Sukhdev Goswami speaking, Rajan, tam tu marishe, pashubuddhi imam johi. After Harikatha is over, Parikshit Maharaj hearing Bhagavad Katha for 7 days continuously, without non-stop Harikatha, marathon Harikatha. And Parikshit Maharaj hearing one warning from Sukhdev Goswami now. What is that warning? Rajan, tvam tu marishe pashubuddhi imam johi. Hey Rajan, you can die. This kind of concession is beastly conception. Hey Rajan, you are going to die. This kind of conception is beastly conception. You should avoid. You should leave it. You should not think that you are going to die. This is beastly conception. Tam tu marishe pashubuddhi imam johi. You can cut and throw. You can cut and throw this kind of wrong conception that you are going to die. Why Maharaj? Same Paramahansa Gurudev before starting Harikatha speaking, Rajan, you should remember all the time, every fraction of second, that you are going to die. Same Paramahansa Gurudev speaking, when the Bhagavad Katha is over, he is giving another warning that Rajan, you are going to die. This kind of beastly conception should be thrown away. Why? Because after hearing Harikatha, there is no question of death. After hearing Harikatha, there is no question of any death. How you are feeling disturbance? After hearing this kind of Harikatha, how you are feeling disturbance? How challenge coming inside your heart? Whereas I am speaking Harikatha from my blood, heart, all the time, I am giving all blood to you. I have no expectation. I have no demand from you. Still you are putting challenge in front of me. How you can survive, I don't know. I want to save you all. Now, Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev gone. Now Paramahansa Gurudev gone. And Parikshit Maharaj concentrating on Parikshit Maharaj. Now Gurudev gone. Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev gone. Now Parikshit Maharaj going to concentrate under the lotus feet of that Bhagavan Sri Krishna. In the meantime, he is surrounded by all thousands of Rishi Mani. He is surrounded by thousands of Rishi Mani. 60,000 Rishi Mani was there in Suktal Khetra at the bank of Ganga. At the bank of Gomati Ganga in Naimisharanya, there are 86,000 devotees, Rishi Manis, they gathered to hear Harikatha. And at the bank of Ganga, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking in front of 60,000 of Rishi Manis all. In the meantime, Uttara Devi, the mother of Parikshit Maharaj, going to reach that place. Immediately, Uttara Devi, the mother of Uttara Devi, the mother of Parikshit Maharaj, reached that place and coming in front of his son. Here, the relationship, of son and mother is not there. This connection not there. Only Uttara Devi wanted to put one question in front of son, Parikshit Maharaj. In front of Parikshit Maharaj, Uttara Devi wanted to put one question. What is that question? That is the starting of Brihat Bhagavatamrita. Tomorrow also I can speak the introductory speech on Bhagavatamrita. Then I can start. Uttara Devi, there is some history of Uttara Devi. Follow. Uttara Devi is a daughter of Virat Raj Kanya. Virat Raj Kanya Uttara Devi. Her bhakti has some speciality. Uttara Devi, her bhakti is more and more advanced. Uttara Devi, her bhakti is more advanced than Kunti Devi. Her bhakti is more advanced than Kunti Devi and Draupadi Devi. Ah, Maharaj, what do you say? Yes. Yes, I can prove like mathematics. Don't put challenge before me. Like mathematics, I can prove. If A is equal to B, if B is equal to C, if C is equal to D, then A must be equal to D. Don't put challenge in front of me. Try to stand on a neutral platform, then you can get all benefit. Otherwise, you can get lost. Be careful. Uttara Devi, her bhakti is more special than the bhakti of Kunti Devi or than the bhakti of Draupadi Devi. What you say, Maharaj? Yes. Yes, I can prove like mathematics. You can remember, Draupadi Devi, she has a nice relationship, friendly relationship with Krishna. Friendly relationship with Krishna. And Kunti Devi also, very special devotional mood. Kunti stop. I already write one book in Bengali, The Speciality of Kunti Devi. It is in Bengali. Who can translate actually? So much glories of Kunti Devi. But the bhakti of Uttara is more advanced. Why I say this way? Only one example I can give. When Dushasan, the brother of Duryodhan, going to take away cloth from the body of Kunti Devi, you can remember. In Mahabharata you can find, that time Kunti Devi expecting that Pitama Bhishma must speak something. Pitama Bhishma can get some solution. Then also, on the Dhritarashtra, they are all senior, you know, Guru Varga, they must find some solution. Or Dronacharya there is an Shastravid. Pitama Bhishma is also knowing, you know, Shastra, or they have big, you know, Shastra Gyani Tattavid, Mahapurush. They must find some solution. When after that he is thinking, now Bhim must come with the club and strike on them, and this kind of illegal thing going on. After that, when no response was there on part of Bhima, he thought Yudhishthira Maharaj can speak something. When all in a possible consolation was over, then ultimately she was left with no alternative. She was left with no alternative but to call Krishna. She was not left with any alternative except calling Krishna. Oh, Krishna, you saved me. Then Krishna came in the form of cloth, and Dushasan could not make Draupadi naked. It's right. Then sometime Draupadi asking to Krishna, someday, why you could not come when you started, you know, insulting me? Krishna told, you didn't call me. The moment you call, I was bound to come. You first depending upon Pitama Vishya, you first depending upon Dronacharya, you first depend upon, you know, on the Dhritarashtra, you depend upon Yudhishthira Maharaj, you depend upon Bhimsena, and finally when you are failure, then you started calling me. So when you started calling me, immediately I came, within fraction of second. Now you see, in devotional field, to depend upon something is not good. At any moment, I am fearless. Any kind of consequence can come in my life. Any kind of challenge. Without any fear, I can go on Harikatha. Because my Harikatha is not mentally concocted. By the mercy of Nityananda speaking, all judgment I'm speaking, all right, Siddhanta, wrong. I have no intention to insult anybody. Even if I can show you direct documents, you know, because I will have to think about future generation to come, not like you, I can do bhakti and leave body. I have to think about future generation, past generation and present generation. So automatically I am bound, it is my responsibility. You are giving me responsibility on me. You are giving responsibility on me to speak neutral Harikatha, at the same time you are putting some restriction on me. What is this? How is that possible? So Draupadi could not prove that extreme dependence of Krishna. But Uttara, you can remember a pure Uttara. When Ashwatthama, you know, Brahmastra giving, finally, I am not going in details. Finally, Ashwatthama wanted to kill the fetus. Fetus means the boy there inside the womb of Uttara Devi. I mean Parikshit. He wanted to kill Parikshit Maharaj before birth. In that case, Krishna was about to climb the chariot. Uttara immediately without depending upon anybody. Uttara without depending upon anybody. Uttara without depending on anybody. Straightway approaching Krishna. Krishna, 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 please save me. Even if this Brahmastra, Astra going to kill me, burn me, I have no objection. Please, no garva me nipattatham. My garba, mind the boy there inside my womb, you please protect. First time, Uttara could approach, but husband is gone. Husband gone. Husband who? Abhimanyu. Husband gone. But father-in-law, Arjun was there, Bhima was there, Yudhishthira Maharaj was there, everybody there. But Uttara directly approaching Krishna. Oh Krishna, please Prabhu, please, if this weapon going to kill me, I have no objection. If this weapon going to kill me, I have no objection, nothing. I like to die. But please save my boy there inside my womb. There's the last, you know, the hereditical balance. Hereditical. Parikshit Maharaj, follow. That Uttara, her bhakti is very, very exceptional bhakti. That Uttara Devi immediately reaching the place of Parikshit Maharaj. Whereas Parikshit Maharaj going to leave body immediately, you know, because 7 days continuously marathon Harikatha going on, and Parikshit Maharaj hearing from the lotus mouth of Shukadeva Goswami Paramahansa Guru. He remember, if there is no Guru, if there is no Guru, be careful. By the help of this Harikatha, you can get initiation. But though this kind of initiation is not exposable in front of devotees, you can come to me, I can show one devotee who can speak all Siddhanta Vichar. He is not initiated by me. He only hearing Harikatha from me. Any kind of Harikatha, he can speak in front of you. He is speaking, Maharaj, maybe previous life I was initiated by you, this life not initiated, but I am surely initiated by your Harikatha. But if you are going to ignore me, my Harikatha, both way, you can face problem both way. Be careful. I have no objection. I have no objection, you can go. Maximum I can cry for you. I couldn't do any benefit for you. You misunderstand me. This way actually, Uttaradevi reached the spot where Parikshit Maharaj was hearing continuous Harikatha from the lotus mouth of Shukadeva Goswami. Now, Mother Uttara going to pray unto the lotus feet of son. There is no relationship with son and mother. Going to pray unto the lotus feet of son, Parikshit Maharaj. Oh my boy! Jachukena padishtam te vatsa nikrishya tasho me swaram prakasaya khipram khiram bodher rivamritam. Oh my boy, oh my son, you have heard all total Bhagavatam, all the mystery of Bhagavatam from the lotus mouth of your Gurudev, Shukadev Goswami. Through this Harikatha, Parikshit Maharaj was initiated. Now Uttara speaking, I like to hear all Nectarian Harikatha in the gist form. I like to hear all Nectarian Harikatha. I like to hear all the Nectarian Harikatha from your lotus mouth, as you have heard from the lotus mouth of your Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev, Shukadev Goswami. Shukadev, please, I like to get this kind of cream. Because, like the churning of this Kira ocean, like the churning of this Kira ocean, those demigods and demons, after churning, they got Amrita. That Amrita is material Amrita. This Amrita cannot give you facility forever. But the Harikatha is speaking, in the name of Prabhupada, I can touch the lotus feet of Prabhupada and speak. I am not going to cheat you all. Maybe you are feeling heavy because I am speaking heavy. But I can promise I am not cheating you. I like to expose the truth, absolute truth. I never wanted to cheat you all. So now, Sukhdev, in front of Parikshit Maharaj, Mother Uttara speaking, as you have heard from the lotus mouth of Sukadev, Paramahansa, I also like to get the cream of that Harikatha Bhagavatam from your lotus mouth, as the cream was collected by those demigods and demons after the churning of that ocean. Here also very important, the whole Bhagavatam is itself cream. Whole Bhagavatam, though, that what is the inner meaning? I can explain tomorrow also. What is the inner meaning, Maharaj? Actually, Bhagavatam is just itself cream. It's all, each and every word, every sentence is Krishna. Krishna parivartita. Krishna in the form of sound incarnation. There cannot be any discardable. There cannot be anything which we can throw away. Whole Bhagavatam is Amrita. Why Uttara speaking this way? Why Uttara speaking? Because time is limited. Time is very limited. 7 days Harikatha gone, Gurudev Parikshit Maharaj, Paramahansa Guru gone, Sukhdev Goswami gone, Parikshit Maharaj is now going to concentrate on the lotus feet of Bhagavan Sri Krishna, so that any time Takhak the snake can come and bite Parikshit Maharaj. And Parikshit Maharaj putting challenge, and Parikshit Maharaj going to put challenge, putting challenge, Parikshit Maharaj putting challenge, Parikshit Maharaj putting challenge in front of everybody. In front of his luck. He is going to speak. Now where is Takhak? Now I am searching, where is Takhak? Now I am searching, where is Takhak? Let Takhak come and bite me. Dasatu alam. Parikshit Maharaj put in challenge. Now where is Takhak? Where is I am searching, where is Takhak? Let Takhak come and bite me. I am ready. I don't fear. Maharaj is written. Parikshit Maharaj is putting challenge. Where is Takhak? Now Dasatu alam. Let Takhak bite me. Let Takhak bite me heavily. I am not going to fear. Because after hearing Harikatha, after hearing Bhagavata Amrita, how it is possible that you cannot get Amrita? After hearing so much Harikatha, how it is possible that you are not going to get Amrita? You are getting some, collecting some poison? How it is possible? Impossible. Now, time is very limited and I can speak tomorrow. Parikshit Maharaj speaking, oh my mother, honorable mother, my beloved mother, now time is very limited. You come at the last moment, Gurudev gone, I am left with, nothing, no time is there. I am left with no time, but still there is some time. Well, by your desire, by your request, your excellent question, I am getting inspiration. I am getting too much inspiration. Oh my mother, I am getting so much, too much inspiration from you. Your question is excellent. Well, though I am left with a very few moment, still, I am supposed to concentrate on the lotus feet of Bhagavan Krishna, but still, I promise you, before leaving body, I can express Bhagavatamrita. So that you can understand that all the cream of bhakti and bhakta, and how tactfully, how nicely Sanatan Goswami Pad guiding us, guiding us up to the last core of Vrindavan. It is called Vrindavan Radha Prema on the Gopi Manjari, last moment. It will take years. Finally, you can reach that Sanatana Goswami wanted to prove that Radha Prema under the guidance of Radharani, that Prema, that love appear with Krishna is topmost, that he wanted to prove in front of you all under the guidance of Radharani, we will have to reach. Aradya Bhagavan Avajasthanayasta Dhamma Vrindavanam Ramma kachit upasana, prajapati vargena jakalpita, simad bhagavatam praman mamalam, pema apamartha mahana, sri chaitanya mahapabhur matam idam tatradarana paraha. That Sanatana Goswami finally can prove. Now, Parikshit Maharaj taking preparation to speak Harikatha. Well, I am going to speak Brihad Bhagavatamrita. I am going to digest all the Harikatha, Bhagavat Katha, spoken by my Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev. And now I am going to get the cream for you. So that you can get consolation. Oh my son, from the lotus mouth of Sukhdev Goswami, you have received Harikatha. like the churning of that Kira Sagar, like the churning of that Kira Sagar, you will have to churn that the ocean of Bhagavatam, and you will have to get the cream of that Bhagavatam. So the meaning for why, you know, I can speak in details tomorrow what Uttaradevi wanted to speak and what Parak Parikshit Maharaj wanted to speak. Bhagavatam is itself Amrita, Sagar, ocean of Amrita. Bhagavat, each and every word is Krishna himself. If somebody can get this kind of meaning, that maybe in Bhagavatam so many bhakta, bhakti and Bhagavan, so many description there. Maybe Uttarama wanted to hear all the secrecy of Gopi Prema. Maybe this reason can be there. Who can say what is the mood of Uttaradevi? Otherwise, why Uttaradevi going to speak this way? I like to get the cream of that Bhagavatam you have heard from the lotus mouth of that kind of judgment. We can speak tomorrow. That kind of judgment we can speak tomorrow without any doubt and suspicion. If you go on hearing about this Harikatha, I can challenge in front of you that I can give some Amrita to you. I can, in the name of Prabhupada, in the name of Guru Varga, I can promise you that you can get some Amrita. I am not going to cheat you. Try to understand over and again what is my mood. Don't try to misunderstand me. It is my request unto your lotus feet. You know, sometime I am bound to speak heavy way. That doesn't mean I have some enmity, I am some, you know, cruelty. Nothing. I am standing on neutral platform. I have to think about past, present and future generation. Not like you. Why am I speaking now? You cannot understand my mood. Dharma prajjita kaitava, dharma prajjita kaitava, atra paramo nirma saranam satam, vedyam vastavam atra vastu sivadam tapotrayonumulanam, simad bhagavati mahamuni krite, kingva parairishvaraha, saddo hridiyavaruddhati krtivihi sutsubhis tatkhanat, Dharma prajjita kaitavatra paramo nirama saranam satam vedyam vastavam atra vastu sivadam tapotrayo unmulanam simad bhagavate mahamuni krite kingva parairishvara saddo hridi avaruddhati atro krithvi krithvi susthavi tatkanat vanchakalpa durvasya ke basindu bevacha pacitanang pavane bhavishnabhyo namo.